really wise about Brittany. And just in case you wondering, where is this father, Queen of England? She's at the hat dresser. Did not have ready for the father. So I don't want nobody to say my Queen was on program and didn't even show up. She had the hat dresser. She didn't know it was going to take all me. When she done at the drive, you just can't comfortable about the drive when you want to comfortable about the drive. I just want to get you smiling. Everybody looking like they so tense. Put some smiles on your face. That's all. Y'all still looking tense.
Ooh, a long time ago. And I asked him this morning, can he speak? And as a great friend, he said, of course. Left he was in town in Atlanta. O.C., we was born and raised in Holmes Tampa. He actually played ball for J.J. Money in the 1990s. Played quarterback. Once he left there, he went to Holmes Jr. and played defensive back and played special teams also. He also walked on at Alcorn State University, special team and also defensive back coach there. He also, once he finished Alcorn State University, he was a grad assistant slash special team assistant coach wise at Alcorn. One reason why I know that because the every step of the way I've been right there with him. Also, on the Alpha bench in Alcorn, O.C. been coached at Ridgewood High School in Louisiana for 2 years. He actually came back to East Mississippi Community College where he coached for 1 year. A couple years later, he went to McPherson College where he coached for 2 years. He spent 8 years for UNC Denver in North Carolina. There, he was over many areas. Recruited a lot of players, defensive back, that's his specialty. Lastly, he also coached at University of West Florida. O.C. has done a lot in recruiting, so he knows what, everything about football. Young people, especially athletes, who's going to give you something that you can not only take for tonight, but pass it on throughout the years. Please give your undivided attention. You have to do this tonight. So, I introduce you, O.C. Williams. Thank you.
You know, anytime I talk to someone, you know, I'm going to try to help you out, you know, any way I can. You know, so for you guys to have these coaches, for these administrators here, you know, that's their livelihood. And you, some of you guys knew what us as coaches made money-wise, you would go in a different profession. But we do it because we love helping you guys become what you can become. And, you know, everyone here has potential to be something, you know, in their life. You know, whatever your job, whatever your profession may take you, you have that opportunity to be there. And you have people that want to help you live. I have my best friend, you know, my best friend from college. You know, I got about four people, including Coach Crack, that I call my best friend. You know, he passed away 2 years ago. You know, 36 years old, he died. You know, and the thing we remembered about him always was he always, anytime you talk to him, he always had a positive word to say. He always had something that's what's going to try to help him. And you as students, you as student athletes, you always around people, administration, coaches, teachers, you always around people that's going to tell you what you should be doing. They're always going to be telling you, right? You're never going to hear one of your teachers or your parent or administrator here on this campus telling you to hang out late or to use drugs or anything like that, to miss practice, things like that. You know, and you got to just take that in and make sure that you use those things because that's what's going to move you forward in life. Not the person that's telling you, man, I wouldn't practice hard if I were you. I wouldn't do this or I wouldn't do that. You should listen to your parents, coaches, teachers. Those are people who are telling you, go to practice, go to bed early, practice hard, be on time. Because those are things that are going to prepare your life. Those are the things that's going to make you get where you want to get to. And everyone in here wants to be a champion. Everyone in here, okay? And when I say champion, I'm not meaning just, oh, I'm winning the trophy, I had the best record, things like that. Being a champion means I'm doing the best I can with what I have. Whatever that may be. You know, if you are a basketball player, baseball player, soccer, football, whatever you may do, I'm the best I can with what I have. Because everyone's not going to be 6'3", everyone's not going to weigh 250 pounds, no, things like that. But whatever I have, I use those things to maximize my opportunity. And wherever that takes me, that's where it takes me. You know, if I'm 10th grade and I'm starting, and then 11th grade I'm a backup, 12th grade I'm a backup, and I'm working hard, I get my diploma, I go to college, I get my degree, you are a champion. Not so much of your record, how many games you won, and who won the trophy, and things like that, but me taking the means I have, doing the best I can, that what allows you to be a champion. And as you move forward, you know, when they started this thing right here, as far as, you know, McLean and William Sullivan and S.B. Marshall coming together, you know, you had a lot of people that was concerned about it. A lot of people, you know, kids going to be fighting, or, you know, who's going to start for the basketball team, who's going to start for the football team and all that. You know, but look what transpired. You know, you look at our football team, look at our basketball team, look at our girls' basketball team. Girls' basketball team is right here. You guys stand up, please. We give these girls a hand. Stand up, basketball team. And I was there. You know, I was in Pensacola, and I kept over there all the scores and everything. And once I found out who was going to win, you know, I was going to be there. Because, you know, it took a lot. A lot of people don't realize how much it took for those girls to become champions. You know, as far as the parents, you got people from Durant and Goodman and Lexington and Chula and Gwynn and Lakeside and all that had to come together, okay? Put all your everything, you know, aside from yourself. And that's what becoming a, you know, once you become a student athlete, that's what it is. Ain't nothing better putting yourself aside to help others to accomplish a goal. You know, you go to the military or you play sports, okay? Those are the main two things that says, okay, I'm gonna put my selfish ways aside to be able to go and help people do something. I'm gonna help them. I know him from Chula, I know him from Lexington, I know him from Goodman, but once you come together as a team, it doesn't matter. You know, you come together as a team, become a family, and that's how you become a champion. Again, how you carry yourself, how you act, how you do those things, okay? Now, it's a few things that you always have to do daily as a person, okay? Always look and carry yourself as a professional. You don't have to be an NBA player or an NFL player to be a professional. You know, when you talk to somebody, you look them in the eye, you speak loud, it don't matter where you're from, okay? It don't matter. You know, I'm from Acona, we got somebody from Lakeside, we got somebody from Gwynn, good, it don't matter, okay? When you meet somebody, you talk to them, you look them in the eye, you speak loud, you speak where they can hear you, you know, and that carries you. Okay, I lived in Florida, I lived in Kansas, I lived in North Carolina. It doesn't matter. Okay, if you talk to somebody, you talk to them as, you know what you're talking about, you look them in the eye, you look straight ahead, you know, you speak with conviction, and it'll help you, it'll carry you, okay? Know your surroundings, okay? Know your surroundings. When you talk to your homegirl, you talk to your homeboy, it's different than when you're talking to one of your coaches, okay? It's different when you're talking to one of your family, one of your parents, your auntie or your grandmother, whoever it is, okay? So it's very important to know your surroundings. And that doesn't matter where you're from, okay? Know your surroundings, know where you are. Always be polite, okay? Always be polite. Sometimes you may not feel what they say, okay? Sometimes I see all the time. Again, me and Twain been friends 20 years. We don't see eye to eye on everything, okay? But sometimes I just say, look, I know what you're saying. And I don't agree with it, not at all, okay? But I know what you're saying. Okay? Because sometimes you gotta be polite. Sometimes you gotta give a little bit of yourself, okay, to be able to move forward. Okay? And the thing is, you guys, you know, I know we got girls and guys coming back next year. You got some people going to college, okay? Everyone going to college, could you stand up next year? Everyone who's going to a university or college, okay?
All right.
Can we give all this a hand? As you prepare to go to college, okay, as you prepare, you had a lot of people on your team. We're talking about the team of your teammates, but you had a lot of people on your team, okay? Most of you didn't show up here on your own. Most of you didn't drive here, okay? Your parents dropped you off. Somebody brought you. Somebody came with you, grandmother, auntie, mama, daddy. Somebody helped you get where you are, okay? And it's very important that once you get to whatever university or college you go to, you don't forget the things that they told you to get you where you are, okay? And that's what happens. I deal with them college students all the time, and I know mom and dad didn't tell them to go down here and act a fool and be out all night and don't go to class, but what happens, you get in college and stuff like that, and you forget those things, okay? Now, the people that's coming back, you try to make sure you do the things that get these guys and girls to college, okay? And if some things are held back, you gotta make sure that you don't do those things, and that's gonna help you move forward, okay? All about athletic administration, okay? You guys gotta understand this, that do not let these students unfulfill their potential, okay? I always believe that. I get kids from all over the country. I get kids from Miami, and they bad now. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you, they are bad, okay? Miami, Dallas, Texas, Memphis. But when they come, you know, I try to hold to a standard, okay? Because I know their parents, all your parents that's out here, all your athletic administration that's here, I know you didn't tell those kids, okay, go down there and curse the coach. Go down there and not, you told them, you sent them to do the best they can, okay? So don't allow the student, if it's your son or your daughter or it's one of your team members, you know, do not allow them to not fulfill their potential. They're being lazy, push them, okay? Because here in Holmes County, I mean, me and Coach Reeves just talked about it just now. We got just as much potential anywhere else, okay? Just as much. Again, I go to Miami recruiting, I go to Memphis, Dallas, okay? And I take our kids over anybody, okay? But we have to make sure, as people from this community, people from this area, we can't let them slack. Okay, we can't have no excuses. It doesn't matter if it's just grandma raising them, or just daddy, or just mama, or just sister, or they got both parents, or the coach, or whoever it is. We got to make sure that we allow these kids to get the best opportunity they can. Don't let them go to sleep if they got homework to do. I mean, check on that stuff, okay? Because when it comes down to the end, it's going to be time. I got a little boy, he's 1 year old, and I'm on his butt already, okay? I'm on him already. You know, to make sure to give him a chance. Because when you get out of that world, it's going to be serious. Okay? It's something serious now. So we got to make sure we're doing a great job with that. Okay? Students. Okay? Students. You guys can be wherever you want to be. Okay? Wherever you want to be. You have, okay? And continue to make our community proud. You guys have been doing it. Okay? Again, a lot of people was very concerned when all this got together. Okay? Especially from an athletic standpoint. You know, got a quarterback from Truman, you got a quarterback from Lex. Who's going to be the quarterback? Who's going to be the running back? Who's going to be the point guard for the girls' team? Who's going to be the point guard for the boys' team? All that stuff, okay? But we was able to get this thing together. And I say we, because I watch it on the internet. I text Coach Patrick about every 2 days, checking on the scores, every game. You know, we try to make sure that we get the kids an opportunity. You as student athletes, you guys got to make sure you maximize it, okay? And continue to be a champion. Wherever you are, whatever you do, wherever this world takes you, okay? This sports, this athletics can take you a lot of places, okay? Wherever it takes you, continue to be a champion, continue to represent Holmes County, and we're proud of you. Thank you.
He also would be doing baseball.
Made their whole season, y'all. Granderson family, Curtis Granderson. He's a Major League Baseball player with the New York Mets. They donated enough money for us to build us a heat cage, which we're still working on. The money's there, but we're trying to decide where we're going to put the heat cage. State-of-the-art facilities are what our kids went to other schools and saw and said, Coach, we need stuff like this. Parents, let's get behind the programs that our children are involved with. Our community is willing to work. Parents, we need you behind them. We got a lot of juniors and sophomores coming back in both softball and baseball. And we're really going to need your help. Martavius Adams. What it was like to participate and to compete. And so competition builds character. Losing makes you better. And if it doesn't make you better, you don't accept losing. Because you can't be a winner. That's the belief that you must have in your mind. Ron Anderson, McKinney Dixon. Zay Rule and Marion Fryer. I have a memento that they put in the newspaper. This is the first picture of my girls softball team. This will always go with me. I'm going to put it in the picture frame and I'm going to remember this. Now, ladies, thank y'all for giving me the best memories of the first year, the next year. We're going to work harder. We're going to do better, young ladies. Thanks for the memories of the first year. We're going to work harder. To the administration, thank you for that opportunity. It's on, y'all. We got to move onward. And now, I'm going to move aside because I got to move onward because I'm headed to Memphis, then to Atlanta, and I might go to Florida.
Williams, Javontis Mike, Damian Southern. Jonathan Ware. Caleb Robinson. Morgan Powell. Jamarcus Caesar. Antarius Butler. Tomas Stevens. Raheem Meeks. Contavious Brown. Cambrian Williams. Jamarcus Friend. Lydarius Kirkman. And Martavius Adams. Martavius Adams. Derek Tillman. Robert Jackson. Paul Reeves. Darius Kirkman. McKinney Hickson. Kewan Edwards. Quintavious Brown. Rodarius English. Kendrick Bloom. Donovan Thomas. Michael Finley. Sean Davis. Kendrick Gaston. Octavius Washington. Rodriguez Harris. Rodney Hint. That's one thing rule out by that. Jamarcus Red. Marcio Jefferson. Delvin Kirkman. Centrell Thurman. Kendarius Marshall. Elijah Love. Quindarius Creeper. Devontae Oliver. Dontavia Greer. Darius Manfair. K. King Darius Siegel. DeAndre Brewer. Gregorius Wilson. Jermaine Moore. Tomas Stevenson. Jay Alexander. Kilimanjaro Edwards. Antoine Padgett. Randall, Stanley Montgomery, Tariq Scott, Ortiz Head, Marzell Gibson, Jason Adams. Justin Adams. Caleb Robinson. Demarius Caesar. Denoria Banks. Jonathan Ware. Sean William, Sean Meats, Darius Riffin, Devonta Smite, Omar Hallion, Darian Poon. Courtney Cow, Deontay Coleman, Joseph Crawford, Raheem Meeks, John Paul Jordan. Jaden Southern, Demetrius Simmons, Cambion Williams, Bobby English, James Bailey, Odarius Goode, Ontarius Butler, Damian Dickens. Darian Oliver, Rydarius Hamer, shows an outstanding work in certain areas. Football is a hard game. I'm 7 years old, and I take the same thing. Football is a hard game. A good game, but a hard game. So these guys, we're going to take our hats off to you. Our quarterback of the year, number 5, Paul Reeves. Young man, I just got through talking to his mama about what we got to do to get him better. He's already good, but what we got to do to get him better. Anybody know me? That's my favorite line. We got to do better. We got to do better. So our offensive lineman of the year, Jonathan Ware. that was one of our good young men. What you can do without a passing game. Our receiver of the year, number 7, McKinney Pixie. Another one of our top guys, like I said, a little big man in the trench. Like I said, you know, he did a lot of good things for us. And I was yes sir, no sir. Couldn't get a better young man than this, mom and dad. I sure appreciate it. I sure appreciate it. Number 30, Kendarius Lanfair. Just take a shot with him. Everybody probably already know it. This guy, his work ethics is just outstanding. He worked out with big guys, the little guys. He always encouraged guys. I mean, it was crazy. It was crazy, you know. So, but at the same time, this is a milestone to show other guys what they can do. He never would take second best for nothing. For nothing. And then before that, he had to get a college scholarship. Martinez Adam, the best player in the world.
Student athlete went out and showed. Basketball team, please, thank you.
coming up. Most improved is Peter Hill. We're just being straight shooters now as an all-around game. Robert Bowen. Defensive player of the year, Jaguar Award goes to Damian Diggs. Big what?
Big 10. Big 10.
Mr. Coach called him the best shooter in Lexington history.
Brave.
Best guy for bench, always the energizing guy.
Brave.
Probably the craziest guy.
Brave. Crazy.
Sixth man of the year and best shooter. Brave.
Brave.
Championship.
Yay!
And ladies. The communities and homes camp came out and supported us in a mighty big way. It didn't seem like we were divided in no way, shape, or form. And I want to thank you all for that, for just coming out and supporting us and being there to push us along. Most of them are not here today. I graduate 8 seniors. They're getting ready for tomorrow. Plus, my younger ones are playing basketball tonight. So I got a couple of them here. But Lord says the same. In 2 weeks, we'll have a ring presenting ceremony to give them their rings, where we'll give most of our trophies. But for the young ladies that are here, we're going to go ahead and present them their banners that we had made for them. Number 33. Number 34, Brittany Webster. And number 4, Alondra Washington. To end our season, I want to say these young ladies wind up being number 1 in 5A and number 1 in the state. And also number 220th in the nation. Their hard work most definitely paid off, and we're gonna try to continue that the next year. Thank you.
Slippers to put on after every night. hotel of your choice in New Orleans where all of this takes place.
Of our students.
Coach Charles Brown did. Matter of fact, he started this in 1996. 2006, to show you how much he had a love for student athletes. In 2006, he was scheduled to have heart surgery. He put his heart surgery off so that he could make it to an athletic banquet to give out the Charles Brown Press Box Award. That's just how much love he had for the young people of Holmes County. So tonight, there are two individuals that are going to be recognized and will receive the Charles Brown Press Box Award. He looked at young folk. He didn't just look at you as being a student athlete. He looked at the impact person. He looked at your attitude, how you carried yourself. He always said, if you got the right attitude, you can go anywhere you want to go. But you got to have the right attitude. In other words, it does not make how good or how great you may be in the sport if the attitude is not right. You won't go very far. So he looked at that, and he really was very passionate about it. Matter of fact, he hated to even see a football player take the head off and drop it on the ground. He didn't like that. He hated to see a football player come out of their gear before the game had ended. He hated to see a football player walk off from the rest of the team. He hated to see a football player when the coach was trying to talk to him. He hated to see a player throw their hand at the coach. He wanted them to just have the right attitude. He said, they keep the right attitude, they going somewhere. So on behalf of late great Coach Brown, we have here his lovely wife, the Danny G. Brown. Our first award goes to a young man who just possessed all of those attributes, who you never saw him being disrespectful. He just was all around very mannerable. And that's none other than Kadarius Lamphere.
Tell you that we demand you to be on time, we demand you to
make the right tackle, make the right play. And as coach, we want to say thank you because even if it's showing a small token, everybody is, but everybody makes a team. Coach Washington, Coach Coach, Coach Dito for setting this up, getting the program ready also. Ms. Randa on the short notice was served and getting the food together. We asked her on Wednesday night. She jumped to it. So we want to say thank you, Ms. Randa, also. Morning, our absence also, and of course, Dr. Denise also. She called me also last other night, and she wanted to make sure that everything goes as planned.
District. I'm sure they all agree with me in saying hats off to all of you. First of all, we'd like to thank parents for all of you.
We thank parents for all that they do. You don't have to do this. You don't have to participate. You don't have to support your children. You don't have to come out of your pockets, but you do, and we're thankful for that. Coaches, all of you and all of these extra hours that you put in for these children, your supplements don't begin to pay you. You probably make a negative amount per hour if you add it up. So we thank you for all of the hard work. And finally, to all of you student athletes, thank you, thank you, thank you. I was going to bring my jukebox. Oh, yeah, got it. Oh, yeah, it's too heavy to put on my shoulder. Jukebox challenge. I don't have a jukebox challenge for you tonight, but I will say this to you. To every one of you, there's greatness within you. Some of you are going to leave here tonight without anything in your hand. You won't have any trophies. You won't have any medallions. You won't have any anything. But it's not what you hold in your hand that makes you great. Greatness is within you. Greatness is within all of us, and you have an obligation to be great in all that you do. Great in the way you walk, great in the way you talk, great in the way you play, great in your academics, great in what you do for your fellow man. You have an obligation to be great, and since there's so much greatness in you, it should certainly exude and come out of you. On behalf of Mr. Smith, as I stand in his absence, I'd like to say once again, thank you, and I'm extremely proud to be a part of the Jaguar Nation.
All right. That's it, y'all. Let's give everybody a hand.